Hey, good morning. We are now going live. Webinar is about to begin. I wish you very, very good morning. For those who are attending from India, it's a very nice, lovely, sunny morning. And of course, we also have some participants other than India, but let's get going. I'm very happy to see all of you here and meeting you here. I've been interacting with your parents because we have colleagues, friends, batchmates, and obviously some of you have met me during the reunion meets also. But here we are meeting for the first time, and I'm really loving it. So let's get going. Let's start the webinar. Before we go ahead, I would like to put a few things in place. Number one, of course, is few rules. The microphones generally should be mute and should not be switched on unless you really have a question. If you do have a question, feel free to make the use of chat option because there is a chat there in your left. Some of you have already started using it. So there's a chat, put it there and we would respond happily. If you have any more queries still, there is a phone number 996906 9637. I'll write it in the chat just now for your benefit. 99690. Let me repeat. 9690 69637. Connect with Gargi. She'll be able to help you out if you have any queries or questions. So let's get going. Right. One more simple this thing will be, you will be getting an email after this webinar asking you about your experience and feedback. Don't forget to give that because we definitely want your feedback. I want to make this more and more interesting, better for all of you, so that in future you benefit the most. And it's not just you. I want to reach out to all the youngsters. I want to connect with everyone and see that they benefit from this interaction. So happy learning. Let's get going. Well, have a look at the photograph on your screen now. The photograph on your screen is something what we called a horse race. It's Mumbai Derby. This is a derby race, which is where the stakes are very high. Now, since it is in Mumbai, we call it Mumbai Stakes. Now, it happens at a place called Mahalakshmi. And most of you would have at least seen the recording of the horse race. And this is where it's a very, 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 very competitive horse race. You know, this is the photograph taken at the time of finish. Now, this is what we call photo finish. Now, photo finish, if you really see, it is very difficult to see with the naked eye that which horse won. So when you really take a high, a photograph with a very, very advanced camera with high speed, you will be able to make out that the horse, which horse has won and which one has come up as runners up. So now if you really look at it, the difference between winner and the number two, how much would it be? Really big or wafer thin? Probably wafer thin. I would rather say it's fraction of a second, millisecond possibly, right? Have a good look at the screen again. It would probably be a fraction of second. So if you really see this, there is not much of a difference between the runners up and the winner. Well then, what is the difference between price? The last I checked up some while ago was this difference. In simple words, the winner takes home a cool of about 1.2 crores and the runners up takes just about 30 lakhs, maybe of one fourth of it. Imagine, you know, the difference between these two in terms of the money that they take home is actually four times the says runners up. But time wise, efforts wise, and the finish wise, that's not the difference. So we can safely say that both the horses are almost running almost with a similar speed. Almost they have been trained well, they have been eating kind of similar food, they have been taken care of well. And this is where although that has happened much, the the winner horse made something different, because of which he walked away home with a very grand prize. Now I want you to look at the photo again and see what has the number one done. You would make it out that the number one has extended his neck at the exact time, and that neck extension has actually helped the horse win. In other words, in the racing language, it's called the nose ahead finish. The nose ahead finish. So in simple words, the nose ahead action of the horse that won actually made the entire difference. Rest, everything else is literally same. So the example tells us very interesting thing. Something that the winner did was not something what the runners-up did. Now you may ask me a question as to what is racing got to do with today's topic, that's personality development. Yes, it has a lot to do. It has so many things to learn from the horse race. And that's where I introduce you to the core philosophy that has made the difference. Winners don't do different things. They do things differently. Winners don't do different things. They do things differently. Shivkhera, the global guru, the global Indian who has motivated, guided, and shown light to millions of people around the world, actually gave us this brilliant piece of thought. This is where we are looking at something which we can apply to the life. Go back to the example of horse racing, and you would realize that winners don't do different things. Both the horses actually must have been trained probably under the same trainer. Both the horses would have had the same quality of, you know, horse food. Both the horses would ran on the same racing track, and the speed also was almost the same. Now then, you look at the photo, or if you recall the photo, you would realize that the number one did the nose ahead and walked away with the prize, a cool prize. That's precisely one of the classic examples of winners don't do different things. They do things differently. So don't you think this applies to us also? We are in a race called career race, and we are running it very hard. We, all of us, whether you have passed your 10th, or whether you are in process of graduating from one of the best colleges, or you're just a graduate and just about to knock the world of corporate life. This is a career race. Then in that case, what makes the difference between the winner and the runners-up? You got my question? What makes the difference between the winner and the runners-up? Yes, it's a question to think, because it's a very high competitive world out there. If I can just give you an example of how much huge competition is out there, you'll be amazed. And the thing here is, about a year ago, if I remember, Indian Railways advertised that they wanted to fill 90,000 vacant posts with Indian Railways. Indian Railways, about a year ago, if I get it right, wanted to fill up vacancies, 90,000 vacancies. And 90,000 vacancies, they advertised it in practically almost everywhere in India, including newspapers and all the online websites, etc. And they invited applications. Now, please tell me, how much applications do you think they would have received? If you can quickly type it in the chat, just put a number. Tell me your guess in the chat quickly. Put it in the chat, guys. Let me know what you're thinking. Just type the number quickly. Just type the number. How many applications do you think they would have received? Okay, Aditya says 10 lakhs. Stuti says about 20,000. Smit says about, what, 2 crores? So, yeah. Krish, 90 lakhs. Interesting. Tanay, about 2 lakhs, I would say. Sarthak, 30 lakhs. Sakshi, I'm not able to see yours. Okay, Sakshi is about a crore, I guess. I'm just reading out randomly. Rishikesh, 5 lakhs. So Sumit says 5 lakhs. Guys, you are way below the mark. The number of applications received were over 2 crores. 2 crores. Can you beat that? 2 crores applications, 2 crores plus applications were received by Indian Railways. So if I may just put it in the different perspective, what is the population of Australia? What is the population of Malaysia? About a crore, possibly. And what's the population of Singapore? About 50 lakhs. So imagine two or three countries put together applying for 90,000 vacancies. Now that's the magnitude of competition out there, guys. That is how the, you know, competition is going to be. And it's going to become more and more tougher as the days go. So guys, it's a competitive race out there. It's a career race that is, you know, is run by all of us, including you, me, of course, and your parents. Of course, I do understand that your parents would be at a different level and you are at a different level. So when we are looking at career race, what will make you a winner? That's the basic question. That's the basic question. Let's ask this basic question a bit more ahead. Let's ask the, take this question a bit more on the thought process and say, what will make you a winner? You know, is it the degree or the syllabus that you study? Well, if degree alone makes a difference, then obviously all of them who pass out from a good college should naturally, you know, would get the jobs automatically, but that doesn't happen. Correct? So you are studying the same degree, possibly, which is studied by thousands of other students. You know, just for an interesting piece of information for your, you know, for your knowledge, that in India we have 38,000 colleges, about 15 lakh schools, and about 850 universities, and the number of students crores. So merely having a degree alone is not gonna help. It will give you a starting point if it is from a good college, let's say or an institute like an IIM or an IIT, or for that matter, a good A-class institution. It can give you a good starting point, but for your career, degree alone is just a good starting point and nothing beyond that. Ask your parents, ask them when was their degree asked last time. Probably some of us don't even remember where our certificates are kept because no one asks later on. So degree is good to start with and may not make you a winner in the long run just to on the basis of it alone. Well, the food, the diet, the kind of junk food, what we eat, whatever it is, will it make a difference? To some extent, the food will definitely keep you fit if you don't just thrive on junk food and if you really go on healthy food. But beyond that, diet alone will not be able to make a difference. Well, some of you may say, yeah, hard work, correct. Question is, does hard work alone is sufficient? No. What we need is a smart work. If hard work was the only criteria, then probably the laborers would have ruled. But that doesn't happen. So smart work may be the option. Or intelligence. Now, some of you say somebody is a very, you know, smart guy. He's born smart. And I am, you see, born average, manufacturing defect, you may call, right? No, the psychology is pretty clear. It says we are all born talented. And this is where the next question is, then if not the degree or the education or the food or this thing or the kind of hard work alone, or if we are all talented, what is it that is gonna make me a winner? What is it that's gonna make me a winner? And the answer, 100% in my mind, in my experience, after meeting thousands and thousands of people, including some of the phenomenally successful people around the world, I would underline phenomenally successful people around, and the answer is yes, that's true. Your personality and actions make you a winner. The way you groom yourself and the actions that you make will make a winner out of you. Mark my words. I can write it on a piece of, you know, an agreement paper and sign it and give it to you and say, this is the truth. Every time, invariably, I have met a successful person, I have analyzed him in depth, and this is what comes out to be the truth. And mind you, I have literally been fortunate enough to have met thousands and thousands of professionals around the world. Not to boast, but just as a statement of fact, I have worked with about 9 to 10 people, nationalities, worked in different environments, and had the chance to work with some of the outstanding leaders. I have personally worked closely with about four CEOs, and that's where, guys and girls, you know, I've studied them and had the chance to really try to find out what makes them successful and what can I learn from them to go ahead. And this is where invariably the answer was, what you do with your personality and the actions that you take will decide what you're going to get in the times to come. That's how true it is. You know, the whole thing here starts with personality and continues with personality, ends with personality. Well, then the question is, what is personality? And the answer is pretty straight. The answer is a little psychological in nature, if you what you're seeing on the screen. But let me make it more simpler for you. The combination of characteristics or qualities that form an individual's distinctive character. Well, that's how psychologists put it, and can't blame them. In simple words, it is a unique combination called you. Unique combination called you. You are different. On this planet, we have about 7.3 billion, right? 7.3 billion people. And these 7.3 billion people, are they same? No, they are unique and different. So every individual is different, including you, your parents, your friends, and everyone around you. And thank God we are different, right? Otherwise, if we were copies of each other, what would have been there to differentiate, right? So personality is your unique combination, a combination that is, you know, that is given to you or gifted to you and you alone. You may think it as a gift, you may think it as a curse, yet you are unique. Psychology believes that's a foundation for, you know, every person is different. There are individual differences, right? Let me take you back a little back in time when there was no internet, there was no technology, there was nothing in terms of what modern things you understand. Back in those days, Greek Empire, Roman Empire. So they had something called persona, P-E-R-S-O-N-A. Persona meant was, you know, in simple words, persona was mask. Have you seen the movie Mask? You know, the movie where he gets a magical mask and he puts it on and then he transforms into something new, something different, and he gets additional powers, and then he gets, you know, he goes around the whole town doing all sorts of tricks and doing good deeds, of course. Persona is mask. So experts do believe that personality comes from the word persona, which means the mask you put on or the kind of face that the world sees. Well, we all put masks, don't we? Right? You know, there's a mask called student. So when you are in school or college, you behave in a different way. At home, you are a, you know, son or a daughter, and you behave in a different way. Look at your parents. They have multiple masks. You know, back at workplace, somebody is a boss, somebody is a colleague. The other mask they wear is a friend. The other mask they wear is a dad or a mom. The other mask they wear is, you know, themselves. So if you really look at it, we all have personalities, and these personalities interact with each other. These personalities literally connect with each other. These personalities result into some actions, and these actions give us results, plain and simple. So personality is nothing but, you know, the kind of mask or what the part of you that world sees visible to the world. Of course, there is an invisible part too. But let's keep things simple. Let's leave that invisible part to the psychologists who actually are researching in depth. But yeah, let me tell you one very interesting thing here, that in spite of over 100 years of research in psychology, we believe that we haven't even scratched the surface in spite of multiple theories, various tests. By the way, speaking about tests, we're going to send you two links after this webinar is over on the email. Those are the links where you can take two fun tests and know more about your personality from a psychology point of view. From psychology point of view, it's a very nice idea to explore yourself. And these two links I'll be sending to you after the webinar is over. Just keep that in mind. Keep looking in your mailbox after the webinar is over. So quick feedback, guys. Can you just tell me how, you know, you're with me by just typing yes in the chat box? Quick feedback, please. I'm waiting for your feedback. You may type it in the box, yes, something like yes. Okay, Tanay says yes. Sarthak says yes. Okay, Sai says yes. Spandan says yes. Great going, guys. Thank you so much. You know, keep giving me feedback. Maitri says yes. Good. Yes, Sumit, I see you saying yes. Cool. So what is personality? You know, personality in simple words is unique you. Coming from the word persona, and of course we've seen that the masks that we wear and the way the world sees us. So how does world see us? World sees us in different ways, you know, different ways. You must have you know, use the word about your friend saying he's cool, you know, she's so irritating, or he's, you know, mad, he's nuts. I know your words are different. I'm just using my simple polite words. Can I use your words? No way, right? So in simple words, the way you look at it. So, you know, world looks at you in many ways. Are you well-dressed or ill-dressed? Are you groomed enough? Or, you know, you're just a kind of a ragamuffin. The way you carry yourself, you know, are you able to put yourself confidently or not? Your manners, etiquette, your communication, interaction, etc., etc. Are you able to sell your ideas, put your ideas confidently, or, you know, you're just a kind of a person who simply keeps in the background, and many other things. So when we talk about personality, we look at many angles. It's not just one part of it. There are many, many, many parts of it. And that's exactly I want you to know, that personality has multiple facets. Personality is not just a simple term, what you see in the mirror. What you see in the mirror is one part of your personality. There are many parts, what you just see on the screen. Some of them are visible to you. Some of them are visible to the world. But yet, when you add them up, it tells us more about you as personality. Correct? So let's get going ahead. I hope you are enjoying. Can I have a quick yes or a no in the chat box, please? Hope you're enjoying. Okay. Thanks, Aditya. Thanks, Pranjali. All right, Arin, thank you. Yes, I'm seeing everyone's. All right, so let's get going. We're talking about, you know, how psychologists see you when they talk about person. So when psychologists see you, they see your characteristics, they see your qualities, and they try to find out your distinctiveness, right? How you're different. But when the world sees you from a practical or a job or a day-to-day life point of view, they see something called KASHGE, and that's a framework. KASHGE, or rather just say KASHE. Let's remove the G for that moment. I would just say KASHE. Now in Marathi it becomes Kashi or Kashe, whatever you can pronounce it as. But the world sees you as a combination of KASHE. G I will take it separately a little later. Cool. So what is that? Let's go ahead and explore, right? Look at the photograph on your screen and tell me if this person approaches you for friendship and says, hey, let's be buddy, come. Would you like to, you know, shake hands and say yes to the friendship? Just what would be your answer? Type it in the chat, please. Yes or no? Would you accept this friendly invite? Yeah, maybe yes, maybe not. Correct. Right? Well, different people have different reactions. Correct? No problem if you don't know him. But if this person walks in into an interview, do you think he'll be selected? Now you tell me your answer. Yeah, now the whole picture is clear. Well, Rishikesh, he may not be selected. He definitely may be rejected unless the, you know, post is called maybe a kind of radio jockey or somebody called, you know, some other weird job, which is not a routine job that, you know, all of us do or profession. But when the same person actually works on himself and goes like this, now you tell me what would happen there? Would the answers change? Yes or no, or maybe? As compared to the previous one? Yeah, so Smith, I take your point. When you're saying one has to look at the personality, I'm just introducing a one simple aspect of the personality, that is how one sees it. We are going to, you know, dive deeper into personality. But if you see a simple change in the grooming or simple change in the way you represent, the outcomes change. People look at you differently. You know, right now we're only looking at a photograph, so we don't know how this person is inside. Is he a wacko, or is he a really gentleman? Is he really kind of, you know, sadist, or a predator, or is he simply a kind of an angel? He may be an angel in you know, bad dress, but unless we start knowing him, we may not be able to understand him. Unless we start observing the way he speaks, or the way he expresses, what are his thoughts, etc. So this is where personality becomes very important. On the face of it, you might reject him. Correct. So this is where, let's continue our exploration in personality. So what is personality development? Now that you've seen personality, what is personality? It is sum total of you, your different combo. You know, let's look at a quick definition of personality. Personality is the personality development is organized pattern of behaviors and attitude that makes a person distinctive. Personality development occurs by the ongoing interaction of temperament, character, and enrollment. Again, from the psychology books. But if you were to look at this entire, you know, definition and tell me one word which is important according to you, what would that word be? Please type in the chat. Please type it in the chat. What is that one word, important word, according to you? According to you, what is that one important word? Okay. Smith says all are important. That's a nice, smart answer, right? Spandan says distinctive. Pranjali, behavior. Organized pattern. Rishikesh, distinctive. Archana, instinctive. Environment. Okay. So I get your, you know, thoughts now. Good. If you ask me, yeah, I really would say almost the entire definition is relevant and important. But if you see organized, one of the crucial aspect of it is organized, and second one is ongoing. These two words make a big difference. You know, if I go to the gym one day and say, you know, I went to the gym, now tomorrow onwards I'm a, you know, great bodybuilder person, so without going to the gym next day, that means, you know, It may not be true. It will definitely fall flat on my face. If I just go in the gym and pick up some random exercises and just say, okay, now I'm going to have a V-shape or biceps or a six-pack ab, well, that may not happen. It has to be an organized way. It has to be an ongoing way. So in simple words, the interaction has to be organized, or the development is organized, and it has to be instinct, you know, ongoing. So when we really look at it, personality development is a continuous self-upgradation, being better, smarter, stronger person every day. That's the important line. You can forget the definition above. All you need to remember is PD is continuous self-upgradation, being a better, smarter, and stronger person every day. You know, on your mobile, you have Android. If you have Android, then your apps upgrade every frequently. Technology upgrades every frequently. Why does it upgrade? Because you have to have better functionalities. You have to have better, you know, more processing power. You have to have more and more features. So technology upgrades frequently to become better. Apps become better. When have you upgraded yourself lastly? That's a question you must ask yourself. If the answer is any time, you know, in past other than yesterday, then that's where the alarm should ring and saying, hey, I did not upgrade myself yesterday. What did I do? All right. So please remember, in the race that I mentioned earlier, the one who keeps on upgrading himself is the one who gets, you know, additional advantage. And that's where PD is a continuous self-upgradation. Period and simple. Correct? So let's go ahead. Let's make it more simpler. Right? What do you upgrade? What do you develop? Yusta, you have remember this equation. This will answer you the question, how do I upgrade myself? How do I develop myself? Answer is this equation, which is coming on your screen. So the equation says physical development, and I'll explain each of that. Don't worry about that. Added to that, what we say mind development or mental development, that will be equivalent to personality development. Now, there are tons and tons of experts saying different things. There are tons and tons of literature available. I have gone through a lot of that, and the sum of that is simple, this equation. Take care of your body or the physical development, take care of your mind or mental development, and you're on the right track of personality development. There you go. So PD is equal to physical development plus mind development. Now, having a smart personality helps. I obviously told you that, you know, a good personality, a developed personality has its own benefits. But what are they? What are they? That's a very simple question, right? So there are multiple benefits that follow. Have a look at on your screen. Your personality has something called core components. I'm going to connect with that. If you continuously work on those components like knowledge, attitude, etc., what you get is a good job and a better life, and that you also enjoy good money, additional rewards like, you know, trips, etc., and a good quality of life with career and growth. So having smart personality definitely helps in really making a big impact on your life. Well, if you really look at it, take my words on the face of it. Look at the numbers that I'm going to share on the screen now, right? I'm going to talk about two highest paid CEOs in the world last year. Can you comprehend this number, guys? Right? Can you comprehend this number on your screen? David Zaslav, CEO of Discovery Communication US, was paid what, 977 crores in 1 year. Talk about Elon Musk, the flamboyant CEO of Tesla, and we're looking at something around 17,000 crores in 1 year. Gosh, that's a mind-boggling number. You know, when I saw these numbers for the first time, what came to my mind? Oh, I would be happily, you know, I would be happy to be their assistant, even at 1% of the cost, the money that they get. I would love to be their assistant. I don't mind, right? So in simple words, my basic question to you is, when they get paid so much, what would be their contribution? What would be their worth? Correct? They must be worth much, much more to their companies who are paying them this money. My next question to you is, were they born with this? Obvious answer is no. None of them were born with this kind of tag on their face or forehead saying, I am worth 17,000 crore. I'm born with that. No, they all developed themselves in the process of their lives. And today they have reached a stage of development and expertise and knowledge and skills, which is where they can command this much of money. Isn't it interesting? 17,000 crores in a year. Amazing. Or 9,000 crores in a year. Mind-boggling, literally. And if they can make it, so can anyone else, because they are human beings. They are also, you know, they're no different from you and me. It's the way how we develop ourselves and make our smart moves or our actions, right? So let's keep it simple. Physical development plus something called mind development is equal to personality development. Now, physical development I'm going to talk about. Mind development will be more of Kashi. That is, what is Kashi? I'll just connect with that in few slides. So guys and girls, you know, have a look at this very clearly. Your mantra is physical development plus Kashi is equal to personality development. Right, so let's get going. The first one, physical development, right? Obviously, as the name says, you know, develop your body. They say in the world of business that body is the only capital that you've got. The rest, everything comes and goes. You know, ask your parents. They would vouch for it. Ask the experts and they would vouch for it. So physical development becomes a hugely important thing, right? Do you know that when we meet people in business scenario, I'm a businessman. So when I meet somebody for the first time, the first thing obviously gets noticed is the upper 20 inch of the body, waist and above. What is the person looking like? The physical strength, the body posture, the handshake, the overall head placement. You know, there is something called body language. If you are interested later on, after the, you know, seminar is over, do send us a feedback on the email, and you know, we can have another small seminar on body language, or you know, how do you work your body language in to create, you know, cool impressions. So body is the first thing that gets noticed. You know, when you meet a stranger, let's say a stranger is, let's say you go on a first date of yours, and the person is not known to you, you are meeting him or her for the first time. Even before you say hi to him or her, you are actually, you know, being seen, how you are walking, how you are dressed up, how is your body posture. And that screams even before you open your mouth. Isn't that cool? In simple words, your body speaks first, you speak later. In any interaction, whether it's business or personal or a date or school or college or anywhere. So when your body does the talking, we call it nonverbal communication or language, better take care of your body well. So physical development is really important. Healthy body, healthy mind. Yeah, you have heard it in school a tons, you know, a thousand times. I know you have written also, you must have dreaded that PE class where you, you know, were made to do a lot of ups and downs and things like that. I still recall. So if you look at it, body is the only capital and healthy body is healthy mind. I don't want to deal with, you know, elaborate that in details. Every day is a new body, literally. I was reading a book called Biology of Belief. It is written by a world-renowned microbiologist, Dr. Bruce Lipton. This is, the guy is brilliant. He has his videos up there on the YouTube, short videos, won't chew your brain much, but should look at them. Bruce Lipton says, you are with the one, what you see in the mirror is an individual image. But biologically, we are a group of cells. Cells, the tiniest elements. And how many cells we are? 50 trillion cells. So imagine looking at the mirror, you see a Shreepad or a, you know, an Aryan, or let's say a Rishikesh. No, it's a group of 50 trillion cells. You know, lakhs of cells every day die, new cells are born and they're replaced. So literally when you sleep and when you wake up, you're not the same. Correct? So biologically, nature keeps on doing its work. It gives a chance to be a new you every day. But when we get up and when we fall into the same habits, the nature helps us, but we don't help ourselves. We again repeat the same old pattern and say, okay, what's up? Chalo, let's go back to the same nonsense routine. So understand, every day is a new you, a new body, a new opportunity. If you take it that way, well, you will benefit literally. Your power time is now. What is power time? Power time is the best time in life. Best time or prime time. In TV shows, you have prime time. What is prime time? When you have maximum number of viewers coming and seeing the TV. So everyone tries to, you know, have their serials and or soaps, etc. in the prime time. Advertisers charge more. TV channels charge more for the prime time advertising. Now, what is prime time in body or life? Physically, you are in the, you know, zone of 18 to 25. And this is where your body is growing very fast. Your nature is maha khush on you. It's giving you bhar bhar ke. So whatever you do, good things or bad things, it will support you. So imagine if you are in a growth phase and you do right kind of exercises, etc., your growth will be strong. And if you have some kind of bad habits and you try to use your power, which is given by nature, to bring and get up all the wrong habits or unhealthy things, well, then you have it. Choice is yours. So your power time is 18 to 25, 26, 27, whatever it is. This is not going to come back again. You ask your parents if they would love to go back. They would happy to trade many things. anything for to you know go back, but it never happens. For us, it's preserving or slightly degeneration that started. So you must have noticed your parents started going bald or probably putting on weight. But look at you, you are actually in the most beautiful phase of life. And this is where physical development becomes crucial. And then obviously grooming plays a very crucial role. How do you present yourself? Typically, like, you know, coming straight out of bed and, you know, untidy, unhealthy appearance, or a very polished, cool, swag kind of thing with very strong, confident appearance. Choice is yours, right? This is where physical development is the starting point. Question. How do you do physical development? Just write one word or one or two words answer in the chat now, please. Let me read what you think about how do you develop physically. Quick. Please put it in the chat. I'll wait for your answers. Exercise. Okay. Workout. Balanced diet. Yoga, push-up. By being healthy. Yoga. Right. Cool. Okay. So a lot of answers coming in. Most of you pointing towards yoga, exercise, some kind of exercise routine. Absolutely. You're right. Cool. I agree with you. You know, when your body is developing, give yourself a right exercise routine. Be it a yoga, I would rather say along with yoga, you must do some kind of weights training. Boy or girl, doesn't matter. Some kind of powerlifting, of course, under the guidance of an expert or a fitness expert who can actually study your body and body metabolism, etc. Have a scientific discussion consultation. Prepare an exercise schedule. Say, for example, Monday being chest workout, Tuesday being back and biceps and things like that. And then obviously, you know, support it with proper food and nutrition. And more importantly, a very critical thing is proper sleep routine. And I know you would be having a smile on your face because we all know the kind of sleep routines we follow. I have my own, you know, relatives, etc. I mean, kids who have seen them, that they sleep pretty late night, awake for night chats and discussions. What discussions? I still don't get it. But yeah, they do discuss things like, you know, whatever things. I believe that they are discussing world economics, politics, etc. But I know I'm wrong. So if you take care of sleep properly, you won't look like zombies. Many of you look like zombies when you are in the class or in the day-to-day life because the sleep deprivation works its own magic. Dark circles, gloomy eyes, lack of concentration, many other things. So if you abuse your body, you will pay for it. That's the golden rule. And if you take care of your body, you will benefit immensely. You don't have to speak anything because your body will do the impression. You will impress the other person without even opening your mouth. So take care of your physical development. Let's move on. Right now, I told you Kash E. That's the framework that we are going to champion. So K for what we call knowledge. Each of this I'm going to explain in a moment from now. A for attitude. S for skills. H for habits. And E for expressions. This is Cash E. This is the framework that champions work on. This is the framework that leaders work on. This is the framework what corporate bosses work on. And this is a framework that I'm going to pass on to you today. Divide your life in five boxes and start working on it. Cash E. Knowledge, attitude, skills, habit, and expressions. Let's start with the first one, knowledge. are you comfortable? Are you enjoying? Can I have a quick yes, please? In the box, a quick yes. Are you enjoying? Finding something new? Quick yes, please. Yes or no, whatever. All right. So thank you. Let's get ahead. Let's go ahead. So let's begin with Kash, or the K, first part of it, Kash. Generally, when I meet students from different colleges or educational institutions, you know, the kind of knowledge that they talk about, or the kind of things that they flaunt, they talk about film stars, they talk about sports icon, they follow XYZ player, and then they know everything about him. Fantastic. Superb. You know, that's something which really amazes me. Correct? Well, they also, if you ask them, what about Tinder? How do you, you know, get onto the Tinder? They would tell you like this, fat, fat, fat. And then they talk about, you know, dark web, the movies and their forthcoming releases, then the books, etc., etc. This is where I'm really impressed. I must tell you, it's impressive. But is it useful? Go out with this knowledge, go to a company and tell them that I know everything about Tinder. You know, I know everything about XYZ film star, you know, it's Tiger Shroff and his affairs. Can you give me, you know, a cool job of a, you know, manager or a great guy out there with fantastic salary package? And they would say, thank you very much, get lost. So this knowledge is not a useful knowledge. I call this useless knowledge. I'm not saying don't have it, but I'm saying minimize it. This knowledge is absolutely useless when it comes to making your career or having a great life. This may get you some cool friendly points when you're in the group, but this will not get you a long-term career advantage. Instead, what kind of knowledge am I looking at? Knowledge of goals. You know, what are the things that I want in life? People don't even know that. You'll be amazed. I'm a coach. I'm a life coach. So I meet people in my day-to-day life, when I do my coaching, when I do my training programs, and I ask them a very simple question. You know, what do you want to achieve in the next 5 years? And people have a question mark saying, what? What are you asking me? When I meet kids from 10th standard, what stream do you want to select? Oh, I don't know, whatever my friends take, or my dad wants me to go for engineering and things like that. Then I meet college students and I ask them, okay, what exactly you plan to do after graduation? Well, I don't know, I'll decide it then. No, that's a dangerous situation, because if you don't know where you're going, listen to me carefully. If you don't know where you're going, well, how do you know you have reached? Should I repeat? If you don't know where you're going, how do you know you have reached there? Correct? Let me take another example. You know, you are on a busy bus terminal where there are hundreds of buses, you know, thousands of people are, you know, going here and there, and you go to one bus which is parked, you have a driver sitting there, and you ask him, you know, uncle, where does it go? And he says it goes to Delhi. Then you go to the next bus. He says, uncle, where does it go? It goes to Manali. He says, uncle, where does it go? It goes to Shimla. Likewise, you explore, 20, 30 buses. Finally, there's a person standing there. He's observing you for a long time. He would come and ask you, son, you know, I've been seeing you asking every bus driver, where does this bus go? Tell me, where do you want to go? If you tell me where do you want to go, I will then help you with the right bus or the correct bus. You don't have to keep on asking hundreds of buses. I will direct you to the right bus. Can you visualize the situation? Yes, right? So this person, this kid who is asking every, you know, bus driver is something called mind. Unless you give mind a goal, mind will keep on wondering, ye kya hai, wo kya hai, isme kya hota hai, achha isme aise hota hai. The whole idea here is, what do you want to achieve? If you are clear about what you want to achieve, then your mind will give all its power to your pursuit. But if you are not clear about what you want to achieve, you will be hell confused. And this is where the self-development also starts with your goal. Have a small goal. Maybe if you've just given 10th, the goal could be getting into a good college. And, you know, if you're a graduate course student, your goal could be securing an O or an A grade in your graduation. If you are just, passed out as a graduate, your goal could be securing a good job securing a entry level position in a multinational company or a national company with certain salary levels. Whatever is the goal, first make it clear, go full powerful speed on it. So knowledge of goal is important. If you are claiming to be, let's say, a graduate in hospitality or hotel management, whatever subject you're talking about, accounts, science, commerce, then you should be an expert onto it. There are tons and tons of students who are graduates but don't know a damn. Same with school kids. When they are talking about subject, all many of them, I find them, what my daughter calls it, Rattu Popat. Right? So they are Rattu Popats, and they just simply, you know, by heart and vomit. That's all they know, nothing more. So if you are talking about, let's say, specialization, you should be, you know, really thorough and expert on it. Then obviously knowledge about what's happening in India, what's happening economically, what's happening in the world. Of course, we know today the only thing happening is Corona. General knowledge, the knowledge about things around you, knowledge about other, you know, important developments, they keep you updated, they keep you sharp. And most importantly, self-knowledge, knowing what are your strengths, knowing what are your weaknesses. Now, obviously, I understand what you may be saying. You may be saying that, but I don't know anything about me. I'm not a, you know, qualified person. I would need somebody to guide me. Yes, I heard it. So, you know, do these tests, which we will email it to you. That will reveal more about you. And of course, consult experts. You know, those, for instance, we have, you know, some of us who would do guide you on this. You know, you can find out your school or college counselor, talk to him or her about your personality types and explore more. Remember, in the world, almost 90% and above job interviews start with one question. Tell me about yourself. That's a question you can answer only if you have good self-knowledge. If you don't have it, you lost it. So self-knowledge is one of the knowledge that is expected. Coming to the A part of it, what kind of attitude do I see around? Well, chalta hai, that's India's national bimari, I call. You know, you will find many people with this attitude saying, chalta hai, aaj nahi karenge, kal karenge. Are development kya hota hai, chalta rehta hai. Well, this chalta hai attitude has actually got us into situation that 130 crore brilliant, strong-minded people, yet the country is at the fifth place, yet the country is lagging far below, you know, compared to the other developed countries. Some of our own people are in other countries, making those countries sharper and stronger, but we cannot. So our country has this attitude, and please don't carry it forward. Have a different attitude. The other problem what I see is, I can't do this because I don't have friends. I can't do this because I don't have a gym nearby. Can't do comes first. Can't do is paralyzing. So don't allow this dangerous element to come near you. The minute you have this thing coming near you, say thank you and say bye-bye to it. I was this, I was that, I'm not going to do this, I'm not, I find it difficult to get up early. All this are nothing but attitudinal statements to actually keep you away from great things that you can do. So what kind of attitude will really benefit you? I can do this, I can top, I can achieve this. There's nothing that can stop me. Let me just do it. There may be difficulties, but I'll do this and I'll make things happen. Life is full of opportunities. You may have had setback, you may have had relationship issue, you may have had, you know, some kind of unpleasant thing, but doesn't matter. Let it be. Whatever has happened. Life is full of opportunities. And this is where the whole idea is. Let's take a simple example, a very cool example, what I say. Let's say if two boys propose one girl, right? And guess what? Both of them are rejected by that girl. So it's the attitude of both the boys that will make a difference. Say, for example, if one boy takes the negative attitude and say, I can't go ahead without this life, without her, I can't think of it, and blah and blah, then he would keep on going down and down, and some fine day he would be depressed and anxious and many other things, and literally not the best copy of himself or version of himself. The other boy says, okay, things do happen. Let me wait for a good opportunity. Somebody better would be in my life. Let me make myself even more better. And he keeps on working on himself. Probably he would be a much better version, and his chances of getting a, you know, good partner would be even smart, better than as compared to the boy. So both the boys face same event in life from the same girl, same outcome, but because of their attitude, they actually went two separate directions and landed up in two separate outcomes. I hope you understand what I mean. So the life is what you take, and you're the one to make it happen. So this is what I call positive attitude. On the right hand side is positive attitude. On the left hand side is kind of destructive or negative attitude. Every moment is your choice. What you choose will make a difference. If you choose negative attitude, you will get negative outcome. and so is positive. So every time when you're faced with a decision, right from getting up in the morning to sleeping at night, if you have a choice, choose positive and see life will give you so many things. Well, wow, what do I talk about skills? Skills, I have seen so many skills in your generation that I'm amazed. You guys are very fast in picking up skills. You know, you beat us hands down. Anything new and you're quick to pick and pick up on it. But what kind of skills I do see? PUBG. Yeah, I know some of you may have had your fill of it. Or gaming. I have seen few boys who want to make a career in gaming. And I keep, you know, suggesting them that, okay, tell me the game which you have mastered. And the answer comes in like PUBG or GTA or whatever it is. And then I tell them that go into the to any company and tell them that I'm a GTA expert of level 6 or level 7. And ask him the salary that they're going to give you. And then they often look at me and say, aise kaise hoga uncle, how does that work? I said, yeah, that's what you're investing your time on. You game for, let's say, hours and hours of day. You destroy your physical capital with some return. You expect some return, but nobody's going to give you a single rupee on such skills. So racing, bike stunts, many other things I've seen. I don't have to elaborate bad things. What kind of skills are essential for your career, for a happy life? Communication skills. So when you're doing personality development, remember skills is a part of your personality, which is going to get you long, long way. So if you look at, you know, skills as a core part of personality development, some skills, I'm just listing them a few, not all of them, because skills are lots and lots of them. I'm picking up few which are very important. Communication skills, the way you talk to each other, the way you talk to strange people, you know, newer people, the way you interact with, you know, people who matter to you, the way you present yourself, presentation skills, the way your interpersonal skills are, how you handle fights, how do you handle, you know, a relationship ups and downs, how do you handle your friends, how do you handle when you go into the workplace, how would you handle your colleagues? All this would come under interpersonal skills. Managing your 24 hours, managing your habits is self-management. Well, I need not elaborate that. I'm sure you have heard enough on that. How do you make decision? Do you make decision because your friend did it or because something inside tells you, just do it, yaar. Let's see. Jo hota hai, dekha jayega. Or do you really, you know, take decisions with decision-making skills or techniques? Some of these, just five of them I have listed. In reality, there are over 15 different skills. Now you may ask me a question, how do I develop it? Yes, I get it. You know, if you ask me, skills can be developed only, or let me put it this way. If you have seen the Fair and Lovely advertisement, 6 hafto mein gorapan, you know, apply the Fair and Lovely and you know, you are cool and smart and wo mardon wali cream wali ad I'm referring to, chup chup ke, right? So unfortunately, there is no Fair and Lovely or Fair and Handsome cream in skills. There is no crash course. There are courses which will tell you what skill is. You learn it, but you will master it only when you practice it. Hours and hours of practice. Remember, no excuse. The other day, I was seeing an interview of Will Smith. How many of you, do you know Will Smith? Say yes or no in the chat, please, if you know him. Will Smith. Some of you, yes, no, yes, no, right? Okay, so some of you don't know, some of you know. Cool. He's the one of the top paid Hollywood actors who has starred in many films like Men in Black or Pursuit of Happiness, MI, you know, I Robot, and many other things. So Will Smith was telling in the interview that he's not a great actor. Remember, he's one of the best actors, but yet he says he's not a great actor. He's not really hugely talented. But where he is better than other actors is his practice of skills. He practices like a mad person. He practices like a sick person. He just practices and practices and practices. So he says, when the other person is sleeping, I'm practicing. When the other person is relaxing, I'm practicing. When the other person is eating, I may be practicing as well. So he says, I do a sickening level of workout and skills practice. And no wonder he's one of the top highest grossers Hollywood actors, right? So this is where practice, 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 and you'll be a skillful person. And other thing is also true, guys. The day you stop practicing, the skill becomes then faded away. It doesn't go away completely, but it fades. And this is where, you know, that's one of the reasons why your parents would still need to learn. That's why we keep on learning, right? I have enrolled for almost 20 plus courses online for upgradation of my skills and knowledge. So I'm still learning. Of course, my learning is more online. Unlike many of you, I don't go to school or college. I wish those days were back. But yeah, skills is a basket and you need to learn. Well, another interesting thing I must tell you right up front, that many of your school or college syllabuses or even postgraduate MBA level syllabuses won't have much skill part of it. So no school or college is going to teach you that. You have to learn by yourselves. Please, please, please. You have to put efforts to learn and acquire skill. Nobody's going to give you like knowledge what they give in school or college. If you want knowledge, you can simply upgrade it using newspapers and books and internet and many other ways. But skills, no. Start today, you'll get benefit later. You cannot develop skill overnight saying, oh my God, tomorrow I have some important thing and I needed this skill ready. So you can't sit at night and, you know, do night study saying, what is this skill? What is this skill? Skill requires time and you got to develop that over a period of time. Well, coming to the final part of, you know, the interaction, habits. Well, what do I say? Plenty of habits. Let me ask your parents and they would have a big list, right? A laundry list saying, ye toh aise hi hai. Pata nahi, mere habits aise nahi hai. Yeah, I do have the same dialogue. But what are the right habits? Sorry. You know, gymming regularly. Taking care of your body, because jaan hai toh jahan hai. I know Modi said it a few days back when he announced 21 days lockdown, but that's fact. Jaan hai to jahan hai. So gymming regularly is the key, and this is where the gym part is very important. Studying regularly as well. Let me tell you a nice cool secret. Why regularly? Way back in the year 1883. I mean about 100 years plus back in time. There was this German scientist named Hermann Ebbinghaus. Hermann Ebbinghaus was researching on something interesting called human memory. And his focus was, why do we forget? How much do we forget? And what should we do? You got it? His focus was, why do we forget? How do we forget? And what to do about it? So he, with experiment, proved to us that we forget almost 80% of what we hear in 24 hours, first 24 hours. In simple words, whatever you are listening to me now, if I ask you tomorrow, you would have forgotten almost 80% of it. It's natural, guys. It's how the brain works. It's like RAM in your computer. When you switch it off, it's gone. Unless you put it into the hard disk and make it a part of the, you know, save it as in the folder, etc., it will never come back to you. The same way, you know, studying regularly, revising what you have studied earlier, will make a big difference. And Ebbinghaus proved us that after 24 hours, you probably remember 20 to 25%. But if you revise it once, that remembering goes up from 20% to about 35 to 40%. Such a double jump. You remember more if you just revise once. If you revise it one more time, that 40% becomes 60%. So how cool it would be if you keep on revising at regular intervals immediately after you've learned it. You can close your eyes and walk in into an exam and score well, right? So regular studying, revising is the key. Reading and self-updating, guys, please. You know, nobody's going to update you on your behalf. It's you who have to take care of yourself. Most of us have, you know, had experience of flying domestically or internationally. So what does that air hostess say when the flight is about to take off? You know, secure your seat belt. You know, in the emergency situation, masks would come down. You have to wear your mask first before you help others. Correct? In Hindi, they say, "Dusron ki sahayata karne se purv, apna nakab khud pehen le." The truth is out there, friends. Unless you help yourself, you will never be able to help others. You will never be able to impress others, and you will never be able to rise in. So take care of yourself. Keep on reading. Keep on updating. You will become smart. You know, smart studies, as I told you, is the way ahead. So right habits, if picked up now, will go a long, long way, really long way. Well, I don't know, but consider yourself fortunate, because we had, and I'm not talking the same dad record, okay? We had a different way of picking up habits. We were forced to pick up the habits. We hated it at that time. We literally cursed our teachers. We were beaten up. I don't think your teacher even touches you. You know, it's, I have seen cases where students have beaten up teachers. So this is where we were beaten up and we literally cried and crept and saying ki kabhi chance mile to is teacher ko main lesson, you know, I'll teach her a lesson or teach him a lesson. But today when I look back, I really say thank you. That feeling of hatred has turned into feeling of gratitude and saying thank you teacher. You know, you hit me then, but I'm ever grateful to you because of the good habits that I was pushed into. So I'm not saying that you get beaten up. All I'm saying is you be smart, pick up the good habits, and that's where you have a long way to go. And never forget, one of the biggest habit is socializing. Keep connecting with people, and not what I mean by, you know, flickering, you know, instant, you know, continuously on Instagram saying what has he updated, what is liking and commenting is not socializing. It's virtualizing is different than socializing is meeting real people, shaking hands with real people, connecting with them face to face. Well guys, we run a counseling center, and there was a case earlier when a husband and wife had met on Facebook, liked each other, chatted for hours and hours, and somehow, you know, met once, twice, and felt that yeah, that's, you know, the it's kind of a marriage made in heaven kind of a stuff. And then they got married, and within 2 years they were at the divorce thing because they realized that they never socialized much. You know, virtual world was way different than the real world. It is actually. So your career, your life, your personality development is all going to benefit you in the real world, not virtual world alone. Virtual world, I don't know when we will start have a living avatar in virtual world. I guess that will be, you know, another 20, 25 years down when, you know, artificial AI and VR would be at its peak. But today, mark my words, you're almost good amount of life you're going to spend in real world with real people. And they have emotions, they have, you know, whims and fancies, they have many other thoughts and ideas. They are unique just like you. So in simple words, unless you give up your mobile, unless you, you know, keep your laptop away and start meeting people and studying them, you know, your skills would be low, your ability to judge people would be low, and the chances of you getting hit by a real person are higher in terms of interactions. But if you keep on meeting with real people, study their behavior, you will be more smarter and wiser. Keep socializing, right? I have seen, you know, socializing is one of the biggest beneficial things. So let me put things this way, that, you know, habits are here to stay, and expressions, the final part of the presentation is expressions. Check your expressions. What is expressions? The way you express yourself to your parents, to your friends, to new people whom you meet, what kind of message you convey, what kind of impression you, you know, express. I have seen typical expressions like rudeness or shyness, whatever you call it, poor communication. When you ask to speak, you would just say hi and then you vanish. You know, you literally avoid people. If your mom, dad tells you, you know, come with me. No, dad, you go. I'm bored. I'm tired. I don't want to be. I'm good with me. Kind of many variations. I don't want to make a long list, but what kind of good expressions are required? Let me just highlight that. Good manners, of course. You've been taught too many things in the school. I'm not going to elaborate that. Social etiquette. Social etiquette are basically the rules of meeting and connecting people in a positive way. Learn from your parents, learn from your, you know, people around you, teachers, see movies, see, you know, stuff, and study them, see how people connect. Social etiquette, right? Then obviously assertiveness is the way of communicating, making a point, what you say, without making an enemy. In simple words, assertiveness is making your point in the communication without making the other person your enemy. So you can be sweet and nice and assertive and try to put your firm point. Learn this. There are courses on assertiveness on online, right? Increase your social connect. Social connect is not on Tinder or, you know, Insta or whatever it is. That's currently a, you know, one useless virtual world which only kills time and entertains you for a moment, but again destroys you in real life. So social connect, positive social connect is what I mean. And of course, the timeless wisdom of being humble, because take any country, take any literature, take any language anywhere in the world, and you would see one of the core, you know, strategies of being successful is humbleness. Pick up any businessman, talking about Bill Gates, talk about, you know, Warren Buffett for that matter, talk about Ratan Tata here, see how humble they are, or Narayan Murthy. You know, humbleness is what people love. You can still be you by being humble. It does not mean accepting everything the other person says, but you can be, you know, you can reject it or regret it with humbleness. You can support somebody with humbleness. And you see, people would love you for that. People would really enjoy being with you. So let's put things together, guys and girls. I think we are reaching towards the end of our discussion. You know, what did we see? If you want to develop your personality, you have to work on your knowledge, which you will get from plenty of sources. I don't need to elaborate. You need to work on positive attitude, because negative attitude comes very naturally and it stays for a longer time. Positive attitude has to be invited, has to be given nurturing, and you can develop. You know, skills, plenty of good skills to pick up, because you are not going to get into the school or college. You have to do it yourselves. Habits are real good habits, which are hard to come by. Bad habits can be taken easily and they can trouble you for a long time. And proper expressions, not improper expressions. So KASHE is the framework using which you can develop yourselves. Remember, don't forget, winners don't do different things. They do things differently. I hope you keep this in your mind for the rest of your life, because I have practiced this all throughout. Your parents would tell me, from a very shy, you know, boy who never used to be with people. You know, I was afraid to speak with girls at one point of time in my college also. I was a chess player, a state level chess player, me and my chess board. I was very happy with it. But later on, I realized that if I want to make a career, well, you have to reach out to people and follow a KSHE formula. I worked on it, and there you go. I benefited hugely, and I'm sharing my success story and formula with you. Choice is yours, time is yours, and success will be yours, right? Guys and girls, thank you so much for being with me. Enough time I've taken of yours. I'm happy to take on your questions. If you have, you can type it out now, or you can, you know, email it to me. I'm typing my email address in the chat. You can always mail it to me. I'm there around the corner. You can always share that with me. If you have any questions, I'm happy to take now. I'm chatting, you know, typing the email address to contact. I hope you enjoyed. Please let me have a quick feedback along with your questions. Of course, we're going to send feedback forms and the emails. So don't forget to check your emails, maybe in our one or couple of hours time. And I hope you enjoyed this. I really wish you all the best and have a big blast, guys. Thank you so much. Your questions, please. Anything, any one thing that you want to say? Oh, G is for grooming, Rishikesh. I have just covered a bit of that in the physical appearance, so I thought of not including it here. G is for grooming. Good question, but I appreciate that. Stuti, you too. I hope you have answered that. Any other question, please? Have you all noted down the email address? Have you all noted down the email address? Can I have a quick yes, please? All right, guys and girls. So I leave it to you with this. You may also blast your question to the connect at skillxglobal.com ID. Thank you so much for being with me. Give my regards to your parents. And if you wish to have some more webinar on, you know, related topic, like basically skills, even more in detail, or communication, in, you know, presentation skills, etc., do drop me an email. And I'm happy to schedule one like this, what we had today. Have a blast and have a wonderful day ahead. Thank you so much. So I'm disconnecting now.